Okay, so, sige. So, can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Is it clear to you? Klaro ba sa inyo, ha?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Sige, so we are moving on. So, again, no, last week is a very interesting one, gito siya nga topic. But we need to, so, in that, from that lesson alone, nakagain na mo one skill in GIS. So, ang inyuhan na lang is, no, amot ninyo, kung nag 11 pa man so far, 11 pa man kabuk nag-submit, I don't know, sabi niyong kuan, but if you are practicing it, no, and then the same time, you can find a really reliable data, on-time data. So, nanagid mo whenever you are hired in an office, so, nanong mo isa ka-skill na pwede ito pang hambog katong creating thematic maps or core of let map. Okay, believe me or not, it is a really in a really interesting to siya nga skill, interesting nga topic, and magamit din na siya eventually if you are going to, no, need to be hired in a relevant nga mga opisina pohon, labi na specifically in a government agency. So right now also, no, we are moving in creating shape files in GIS. If you notice in our previous nga mga previous na tong exercises, we have utilized the shape files, right? Tama ba ko? Hello, naka-remember pa mo or why na hinumduman?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, we are utilizing. Nag-utilize na lang ta ba? Nana, there are already existing shape files and we are just using it. So now in this session, no, kita mismo ang mabuhat sa shape files, no? It's really a good topic. And take note, no, if you have this skill as well, katong pag-create po sa heat maps, so you have no couple of skills na magamit sa GIS mapping, no? So pwede na mo ma-hire sa planning office sa any other agency, no? Nanamoy skill ba? And so kani, no, it's a kanang magamit ginato ni siya. We are creating right now shape files in GIS. Okay, so let's discuss at the first. Actually, gamayra man, mabulang man ang discussion. And we will move on to demonstration na dayon. Okay, so shape files in GIS. Sa ding shape file, dahil it is a vector file format, right? Diba? Vector file man siya. We know that already. Na what is the use to represent real world objects on a map by recording information about their location, their shape, and their properties. Okay, inside dapat di ay naasa isa ka shape file, the location, the shape, and the properties. Okay, previously, in our previous lessons, we have already gone through with point, line, and polygon. Diba? They are the three basic types of shape files or vector data files na sila. Or types, no? Vector data types. Okay, so again, be reminded that a single XY coordinate, kung XY coordinate daw, single XY coordinate, no, represents a geographic feature in a point file. So point, whenever we say that it is on point na siya, insay gina-represent ana, insay naagid ana niya nga data, it is the X and Y coordinates or the location. Points on a map can represent number of objects such as towns. So take note ha, you have to determine insay the nga what are the objects in a map nga proper gamiton si point. So take note, it could be a town, wind turbines, garbage cans, it could be pwede po siya poles, pwede po siya towers, no, anything that has tawag ani. Pwede siya kanang wala gani siya area, no? Pwede naman po na area but most appropriately the objects should be kanang walay area. That can be represented only by X and Y coordinates. One pinaka proper, or shall we say, if that object on a map, wala siya area, and then ang naaalang gid sa iya is X and Y coordinates. So the most appropriate na gamiton ana na basic type is the point. Okay? So, and we have also the lines. Okay? Insa nang lines? Indicate features that connect at least, no? Kung naado ka i-connect at least two X and Y coordinates, and have length, kung naa siya property nga length, and then naa siya direction, pero wala siya area. So lines ang gamiton. Okay, like roads, water lines, and rivers. Diba? If you notice in our shape files, no? Previously used nga shape files na to, the lines are represented by roads, or I mean, the roads, water lines, and rivers, etc. are represented by lines. Okay? Moreover, no? When we say polygon, kanon siya siya gamiton? So polygon, or what is the definition of polygon first, no? Two-dimensional closed figure na siya that represents an area. So again, if that object on the map na siya area. See, so ang pinaka-appropriate, the most appropriate vector data type, no? Nga imong gamiton is a polygon, no? And at least na siya three sides. Okay, polygon, mga three polygon, okay? So like buildings, agricultural fields, and other boundaries are represented by polygon. So, klaro ang kalahian sa tulo kabuok, types of shape files.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, how about the others? How about the others? Aiden lang nagtubag. How about others? Nasabtan ninyo ang kalahian sa tulo?
Yes, please.
Okay, si Mark.
Yes, ma'am.
Agree. How about the others? Arian? How about the others? Sirit lang sa, i-review lang sa mga recording. Okay, so let's move on. Let's move on. Now, we are going to create shape files. Masugod na ta. Okay, so, let me show you. In your Google Classroom, I've already uploaded and posted the open layers. Okay, we have a material there, open layers zip. So, it is not a shape file, but it is a plugin. Kita ninyo sa inyong screen?
Yes, so.
Okay, so, ito nga, balin ako akong presentation. Yan, so open layers na siya nga zip. If you download it, ang unod anak niya is like this. Okay, Tokero, noted. So, if you open that, open layers, so plug-in na siya, so inga na ang sulod niya. So, dili siya shape files, but files siya, Pythons, okay, Python files, no, or files na created in Python. Okay, so, and then, please do not try to, actually, daghan kay kogi, agian nga, pangitaon yun ang right plugin, ani, ingani mo good siya. So, we also have, nakita po na ko, downloadable siya, in the internet, open layer siya nga plugin, but it is not, wait lang ha, makita niyo sa kong screen, open layer, sana yun. Ay, gidelete din ako. Okay, do not download download na katong open layers nga plugin. Sige na ra, dai. Kaning sa QGIS because it is not working on 3.16 version. So it only works on 2.9 version 2.99 pababa. Mugana siya. But in pataas no, like sa kuha 3.16 dili siya mugana, no. And also, upon reading the forums, dagan siya bugs pa, under development pa siya, gina-fix pa ang bugs ani. So, unsay gibuhat na ako, nangita ko other plugin. Open layer gapon siya, but I found it in a GitHub. Not perfect, but dili siya perfect. It is not free of bugs, pero we can utilize. So, ipakita na ko later. No? Kita na ko later saan siya paggamit. Okay, so, let me move on. Yan. In our QGIS. So, again, the target for this demonstration is to create a shape file. Okay, so please bear with me. Okay, so we need to, nganong na-plug in? Because we need, in creating a shape file, manggod, we need a base map. Because nganong, when we create a shape file, kinahanglan nato natay asa mang kumagbasi dahil sa ako ang buhaton ng shapes. Mangita kong tindahan, mangita ko og, like for example, magbuhat ko og shape files for roads. Yung wala ko makita ng roads. Or magbuhat ko og shape files for buildings. Wala man ko makita ng buildings, the real, real-time na building. So, kinahanglan na to. In connection to that, no, so we need a baseline map. Muna niya siya kung gingon in our previous lessons. Whenever you have a raster map, no, nagana siya sa pinakailalom, it will serve as your base layer or baseline layer. So na siya sa pinakailalom. So this time mo tong gamit sa plugin. So as inyo ha to siyang what is the first step? You have to go to the plugins ng menu, and then nadi hay manage and install plugin. In my case, na-install na ako siya, but I want you to see giunsa na ako siya. So first na siya all installed, not installed. Dari tayo sa install from zip. Locate the zip file nga katong akong gihatag sa inyo ha. Excuse me. Sa i-post na ko sa inyo hang classroom. So, if you can locate it, so pangitao ninyo, like mine, asa na to? Yan. Select the zip file and then open lang siya and then install plugin. Ang makabutan nga na niya, install plugin. Kani, nasto nga, install plugin na siya. Pero ako, dili na ako siya usabon because possibly if we have the same version of QGIS na siya error mo gawas, but nevertheless pwede ra, maski na siya error, pwede ra na to gamiton i-utilize si open layers nga plugin. Okay, nasabtan to siya nga part.
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
first install the plugin. Yes, after ma'am. You install the plugin, go to the web na menu. Web na menu, as you can see, we have open layers nga plugin na. Nag-activate na siya. So, insa na, adi ha. Okay, the good thing about open layers na ay Google Maps, na, halos tanan. Na, when you say mapping, no, or maps, kinds of map na adi ha. Si Google Maps, OpenStreetMap, OSM, Bing, etc. Si Apple, even Wikimedia, na asya. Pero ang problema mong na to is, dili up si ang developer sa plugin is under ano pa siya, naga-fix pa siya sa bug, okay? So that's why so karon, so di nato siya fully pagid magamit ba. So but anyways, sige, if you have those, ako na gamit na ko siya fully, na fully utilized na ko siya when before I used 2.8 na version sa QGIS, but you know, pag outdated na ganing version, nanap na siya problema sa other ng mga plugins or other ng libraries. So that's why we need to really level up, but good tag mag-update yun ta. So that's why we need to use the latest version, 3.16. And now, in connection to this, no, sa atuang kwan, open layers plugin, dili na to magana ako. Ako na nang i-check niya, dili na to magamit si Google Maps. Lagan siya error. Si OpenStreetMap. That's why I resort in using the Bing Maps. Okay? In this exercise, we are going to use the Bing Maps. Okay, so and then we will choose the tuloy mo na ka klase ng mapas na sa Bing, road, aerial, and aerial with labels. So, ako ang na-try is aerial with labels. So, let us check this one. Oh, ningon pa gani siya ako nga. Not supported daw. Nagkaroon siyang error, pero nevertheless, magamit mo na to siya. Okay, so let me just close this error. And then, let's zoom in. Ang itao na to, ito ang lugar. Yan. Actually, si Bing Map, dili siya, ano, eh, kanina nasa open layer na plugin, dili siya updated yung kayo. But for the sake of just practicing, no, or having an experience of creating shapefiles, nandito na to siya this time. Okay, just zoom in. Excuse me. So, para madali na ko siya, in this case, amo ang dapit ang ako ang kanon. Yes, dili mo di pa properly labeled ang Bing Maps eh. And again, dili siya real time, no? Dili siya updated, I mean, okay? Okay. So, kani this is Luna Street. So kani nasa ako ang naka ano sa akong mouse pointer, this is Luna Street, amo ani dapit. So, kani ako pilion because familiar man ko sa location. Okay. Okay, at your end, can you see the map?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, me.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
So first shape, okay, what comes in my mind, we are going to create a shape file in the form of what types of polygons. Okay, polygons. And if I survey the areas of my residence, ang naadiha, first good thing akong nakuan is ang pinakadool sa mo is naagoy place of worship, okay, na simbahan, no, in which our church. So that's why my first thing that come to my mind. So I will create a shapefile for places of worship. If you notice in your previous shapefiles, nagigamit na po places of worship or POW. Kato nakabutang ng POW. So next, if we have already loaded the base map. Okay, this is in raster ha. Raster na siya nga date. Raster na siya nga image or raster na siya nga map. Now we are going to patong, no, a shapefile we create. Polygon ang una nato gamiton. Again, places of worship. Okay, so let's go to the layer, and let's create layer and then new shape file layer. Okay, new shape file layer. Okay, so just click it and then ato asyang isave. Asa na to siya isave? So that's why we need to click the browse. I have already created a folder for that. Nakoy my shape files. Yan, just click lang nimo save, pasabot diyan nimo siya i-save later, okay? Okay. Wait, file name pa dai. So this shape is called Places of Worship. Yan. And then so geometry type or isa siya na klase, okay nga shape file. So again, polygon at buhaton karon. And then leave as is na siya kanang dimensions and the kaning IPSG ang isa ihang tawag ani isang iyang type of kanang sa kuan pa ba geographic type no or sa ano siya system location system. Okay, so just leave as is na okay, para di kayo malibog unsa una siya paggamit. So next is unsa gito siya. Now, places of worship name, if you notice, if you can recall the attribute data table, diba? Natay mga fields dito. Mauni ang ipasabot sa field dare. Okay, we are creating a new field. Take note, sa ubos ani, nanay ID daan. So, it is a default na siya that we already have an ID. No, nanay ID para anang field. Okay, para sa shape, no? Nanay siya one field. Now, we add a field. Pangalan na to siya, name. Okay, this name of the place of worship. So, name. So, okay na siyang length siguro. Then, ang iyang type is text or text data. Then, just click the add to fields list. Yan. So, if you notice, nanatay duha ka fields. ID and name. So, for now, that is okay. So, ato lang sa na siya. Kana lang sa, but if you intend nga, gusto pa ninyo nga naailaing attribute data ang inyong places of worship o kana nga shape file, you can add more. Say, for example, address ba niya? Okay, sige. Pwede na to kanon siguro. Na address. Textual gihapon 80 na length. Sige, pwede. So add to fields list. Yan. And then so on and so forth. Okay, as many fields as you want. Pwede ra gyud ta mag-add. Okay? And then just okay. Okay. So nabay na itabo. Unsa na ah? Na-create na nato ang shape layer, okay, or the shape file. Now, sana ready na ta because we already have created the shape file and we have already created the attribute table. Yan, mayroon na siya o. Oh. If you see the attribute table, nanatay field. So we are ready in creating the shape files. Next is to, yan, i-on na to ang toggle editing. And then right behind it, no, na add polygon picture because we are creating a polygon. So that's why click na to na siya. And then we create a polygon like this one. Kani, familiar magod ko, no? Because this is our church. So, kabalugi ko nga. Oops. Good lang, ha? Yan. Ana lang ko to yung zoom. So, we'll create a... Na, mura taga drawing. Square lang, ana. Square or polygon. No, now yun siya sides. Yan. And after that, if you have created, maklaro ba siyang ending? Ako kayo mag-zoom eh, kasi, ano, limited ay yung zoom. But can you
maklaro,
see
ma'am,
na nag-drawing ko? Okay, after you created the polygon para mo gawas na siya mo gawas ang next niya property. I-right click mo siya. Right click mo pasabot nag-end na imong pagbuhat sa polygon. Yan. So naa siya ID and then naa siya name and address. So for this instance magsugod tag 1. Okay? So name. So that is our church. So, pangalan nako siya. Pangalan sa church na is kana diha dapita is Lighthouse Christian Fellowship Digos. Address niya is Luna Street, yan, corner Balintawak. So for example lang, no, Digo City. Yan. Okay, so yan. So naan na siya, na-create na shape. Okay? So if we are going to turn off our base map, okay, si shape lang na bilin. Okay, so let's check ha. Let's display the label of that shape. Okay, so label, single labels, name. Okay, I selected the name. You see, no, ang yung attributes na arabyud siya. Maugyud as is. And then, text, it's a color. I will select the, I want the white. And then, bufferan lang ako siya. Buffer lang. Okay, dark, 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 dark. Okay, so na siya name. And then, if we want to create another, nakita ni mo, in this area, napaila in place of worship. So, this one, like this one. Okay, example. Example lang. Yeah, create ko dari. Okay, nakita. Okay. And then, sige, number 2 na siya. And then, sige, so for example, ko na siya. Christian Life Center. A church. And address niya is Luna Street. Ano ba yan? Corner Tandang Sora ata na di hadapita. Tandang Sora. Diba? But again ha, programming ano ha? Programming siya nga, is it ba tawag ni? Programming siya nga rules. If again, kanik, for the sake of ano lang, illustration nga madali ta. You can chop-chop the ano ha, the address like barangay, municipality, or street, barangay, municipality or city, and then the province. Kasi for the sake of ano lang, demonstration para madali ta. Pero if in programming rules, dapat ingatuon na to siya pagtagtag si attributes para later on, no, we can have kanang mga queries ba, no, mag-group na to ng tuang data. Sige, just for the sake. Okay, so now we have 2 shape files, or 1 shape file, but we have created 2 ng mga sa to ni polygons. Okay, so if we are going to turn off the base map, ayan na siya. And then if we are going to check on our folder, ayan. So naatay, you see? So katong ato ang mga gipanggamit ni shape, shape files dati, no, same, di ba? Pareha sila. So naatay DBF, naatay SHF, PRG, etc., etc. So automatic si QGIS ang nag-create para ana. Okay, so nasabtan so far. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Excuse me.
Okay, thank you.
Then I will clear.
Okay, so again, next. So, we try to use the point. So, again, unsa ganito gamit sa point? Unsa pinaka appropriate na gamitan sa point?
Kanang walay coordinates, ma'am.
Walay coordinates or na?
Walay dili, kanang walay area, kanang walay area specific coordinates lang.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, most appropriately. Pero again ha, there are instances po na pwede rin po siya gamitin like for hospitals, grocery stores, pwede rin siya na. Pero the most appropriate na gamitan niya is like poles, towers, wind turbines, etc. Okay, so now let's just assume ha. Let's assume nga natin mga tower dari. Gusto na ako siguro mabuhat o tower cell sites. Cell sites, so tawag ni. So tawag na gani, mobile networks, towers. Okay, so let's go back to layer, create layer, new shapefile layer, and then as I save, so gusto na ako, dari lang gapon, same lang gapon na folder sa my shapefiles, and then I will call the shapefile as towers, or dagan mong klaseng towers, so mobile networks, networks, towers, and then point, and then first nanatay ID ni, so name, and then sige pinana siya, sorry, add to fields, and then okay, so mobile networks, so toggle editing, and then if you see lahi ang yang gi-activate pag net pag point siya, so let's click this add point feature, and then say for example that is the all na lang ni kani dari the pita na ana siya ay tower. So, ID number 1, and then, yahang name niya is Globe. Globe dash Luna Strip. Yan. So, i-on na to ang label. Yan, name, text. Yan. Buffer. So, nana, dara, si Globe. And then, we create another. So, just click di kanidari dapita. Siguro na si, yan, gitaparan siya ni Smart. Luna Street Gapon. Okay, ayan. So, if you notice, if we check again, CB, create na siya. And then, wait, ha? And then, if we check in the folder, ayan. So, na-create na si Mobile Networks na Shapefile. Okay, nakuha. Sa'yo na, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Sa'yo, okay, no? So, if you can create, pag kugihan kayo mo mag-create, ani, actually, if you are very kugihan, no, you can, ingani yung notice na ako, kadalasan magmita kong shift files, no, upabayad sila ba? Kalain po na nang buwan, eh. Upabayad mo na sila, mag-carting-carting man dahil yun. So, if kugihan mo magbuhat ng shift files, actually, you can sell your shift files online. So, ana siya kanindot. So, it is really a skill. So, therefore, so, kamo, no, if you want to focus on this, no, improve ninyo yung skill. On this in creating shapefiles. I tell you, daghan kayong nangitag shapefiles, no? In regarding, with regards to GIS mapping. Okay, so, so that's the purpose of our, tawag ani? Of our discussion or our demonstration. So, if you want to print this namoy output ani, so you can go to anong dayon, no? Katong Print Composer. No, I have already discussed about Print Composer. Pwede mo mubuhat niya, i-undergo ninyo para lang na mo'y JPEG aning inyuhang gibuhat nga shapefiles. But again, the purpose of creating shapefiles is para nataning mga kani shapefiles itself para magamit na to in other usage para sa atong GIS mapping. Okay, so question?
Ang sa line, ma'am, point to point siya or ikaw mismo mag-drawing?
Ikaw mismo mag-drawing. So then let's try. Ha? Let's try. Wait lang. Isa may line? Road, no?
Road.
Okay. And then let's try line. Okay. And then, unsa ba? Name. Yan. Sige. Line. Yan. So let's use, ano ba? Isa ba pwede gamitin? Vertex or layer? Yan, add line feature. So, say for example, la kanidari dapita. Ayan. O, na-drag lang, click lang siya. Point to point. And then,
okay.
Na right click lang yapon, ID1, Luna Street. Ayan. So, yan. So, natay line. Natay road. Okay, so again, input label. Okay. Single labels. Yan, sana na siya. Okay, so. Ayan. So if you check. Road. Okay, so other questions? Hello. Other questions? Wala na. Dali ra no. So for your exercise, so actually wala pa na ako na type ang exercise na naghula nga nagahot ko sa time. Anyways, for your exercise, you have to create shapes. Igamitin niyo ang tulo, point, line, and tawag ani, polygon. So for each type of shape file, you need to create at least five, na like polygons, Okay? 5 points and 5 lines. Okay, again, for your exercise, you need to create... You need to create, no, shape files for point. Oh, Sedi, paki-ano daw yung mga... ako nalang mute ni mo. Ayan. So, you need to create a point, a line, and a polygon, and shape files for each type of polygon, for each type of shape, you need to create at least five objects, or like 5 polygons, no? 5 points, 5 lines. Nasabtan siya.
Yes, miss.
Yes, po.
Okay,
yes,
so, as much as possible, okay, I don't want to see repetitive ng mga objects. Okay, I don't want to see repetitive ng objects. Else, I will think na nagkopyahan na mo, nag-copy-paste na mo sa inyong classmate. If you don't want, may ipa-video na ko ang inyong exercise. If you don't want, kabalo ko, di ganun ganahan mag-record video. Okay, please, think of objects na dili pareha sa inyong classmates. And think of locations in which unique sa inyong classmates. Okay, like, kung asa mo nagpuyo, so possibly, pwede giragin kayo dito. Like, na, taga-matanaw mo, barangay, sabay barangay sa matanaw. Bangkal, taga-bangkal mo, sige, pabuhat mo diyan sa bangkal, unsa inyong pwede buhatan o shape files. Okay? So, nagkasinabot ta, para na, ang isabit ninyo, ang shape files. Ang shape files. Other questions?
Naka-zip, ma'am.
Kamu bahala, if you want to zip it, no, pag-upload din yun. Yeah, pwede na kayo para mas dali, para sa mas madali upload.
Okay, ma'am, thank you.
Ang gibot pasabot na 5, ma'am, kay kanang 5 ka shape files or 5 ka shape sa isa ka file?
No, 5 ka shape. 5 ka, like ba, pareha akong gibuhat, di ba? Nabuhat ko og places of worship, yeah. Na shape. So, 5 ka places of worship, yung buhaton.
Ah, okay, okay.
Okay, kung, so sa point, no, sa point nga type, okay, like towers, so 5 ka towers ang inyong ikuan, buhaton, like ni no, na globe, smart, sa pa na siya, etc. So sa line, kung dalan siya, roads, o 5 ka dalan ang inyong buhaton sa inyong in each shape file. Okay, nakuha?
Yes, ma'am.
Take note, tanaw sa, okay, tanaw sa akong layer, ha, tanaw akong layers, na lang ko itulok layers diha, di ba? Na ako'y places of worship, na ako'y mobile networks, at na ako'y road. For each of that, taglima inyong buhaton. At least, if ganahan kayo mo, wala, ganado kayo kumabuhat sa shape files, kay gwapo kayo siya, tanawon. Eh, daghan na. Dali lang, gamay ang effort na eh. Hastang sayo na sa exercise. Okay? Any other question?
Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Wala na. Wala na. Oh, as much as possible, real world, ha? Actual. Nasa'y nasa actual ninyo. Actuality. Nasa'y nasa inyong locality, I mean. Okay. So, if wala na question, so I will upload later the video recording as well as I will upload the module for this lesson. And again, your assignment will due next week. 7 days na siya. Mag-open. It will close after 7 days. A question. Wala na. So, if there are no other questions, so let's go back to your face.